London Olympic Games. The Gabon, Anthony Obame. In fact, this will be Gabon's first ever Olympic medal. Olympic competition at its best, and what about the high contact there? Is that a gold medal move from Anthony Obame of Gabon? Present their thoughts to the referee. There's three mat judges, so there must be a winner. Anthony Obame of Gabon.
Straight away. Wow.
Oh.
Good attempt from Anthony Obame.
Oh, that was close. Now Anthony Obame has a good front leg. Good, very good front leg. It's like he has a radar, like a scanner.
I think that looked
the
right.
Other.
Did he grab? No, I don't think he grabbed
yes.
either.
Ah, maybe.
No.
A touch and hold, perhaps.
You see?
Really?
No.
No, I don't think
so.
Oh,
he touch it?
Very close. Very close. I wouldn't like to be the video referee on this one.
I think from that angle, yeah.
From this?
And this one. Yeah.
Lovely.
This will be a great story, though, if Anthony wins this World Championship.
The silence will be
wonderful.
Only 1 minute.
Yeah, exactly.
Only 1 minute of this final.
David Cooper almost lost his tie there in the centre of the ring, but it is a significant moment in this match.
That would have made it interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
He's in fire.
He wants it.
Yeah, Mardani just easing into that distance. Walking in, trying to cover.
I think Iran's a little bit wary to go in with that front leg because...
The reverse.
Yeah, Anthony has that exactly there. Oh, 2 points there. To the back as well. To the back of the body. When they were juniors, seniors.
Yeah.
And he has the same. Just, they're all there cheering for Gabon. This is such an amazing fight.
Well, it's underway now. The third and potentially final round here on the men's heavyweight. Good attempt from Mardani.
A little bit hard,
not
enough commitment there from Iran.
Lacked conviction, lacked accuracy, and good cover from Anthony Obame, trying to hang on to this 4-point lead, but he can't be too passive.
That was very beautiful. The precision was exceptional.
He's going to have to fight now. He's got a minute and 20 seconds left. He's going to battle all the way for this one. He came into the match injured, a heavy blow to the hand. Blood and guts required. There's a front leg hook again.
Oh, wow.
Beautiful.
A little bit controversial, but it doesn't matter though, you know. I think it would be difficult for the Iranian to pull this back anyway.
Yeah, for sure.
Ramos.
Maybe Ramos
should go on the podium, I think with
think.
Anthony together.
I think he would jump from the...
I think he's definitely going to go onto the ring.
Well,
no mistake.
There's still some time. Let's focus. Because Anthony Obame has to be very careful. Mardani has given
seconds.
His best. It's 10 seconds from glory here. Wow. Obame has had
great
this situation
fight.
Before.
Play with the hip leg.
Little
great
bit of history
that.
Here. The crowd counts it down. Let's look at it. 2013 WTF Heavyweight Champion Anthony Obame.
Wow.
Look at the reaction.
Go on, Ramos. Get up there.
It's so beautiful.
That's amazing. It's amazing. There we go. Go on, Ramos. Go on.
His mother is here.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, the mother is here
in the public.
Juan Antonio Aram was so emotional.
Oh,
you can see what it means
so
to him.
Beautiful.
He did a lot. Every day he trained him. So.
Wow.
Fantastic relationship between coach and player.
Yeah.
And a great fight from Mardani. He gave it all
definitely.
The good.
He did. You know what? Anthony was just a different class.
Yeah.
A different class. And, you know, the Iranian athlete, I think, should be happy with his performance. I think he did his best, but I think no one could beat Anthony today.
He did the perfect one.
Je suis très satisfait parce que j'ai disputé beaucoup de finales. J'ai fait la Coupe du Gabon, j'ai fait médaille d'argent, les Jeux africains, médaille d'argent, les championnats du monde universitaire, médaille d'argent, les Jeux olympiques de Londres l'année dernière, médaille d'argent. Et je suis content aujourd'hui d'avoir mon premier titre de champion du monde.
Quel était le moment le plus difficile aujourd'hui?
Le moment le plus difficile, c'était tous les combats. tous les combats, surtout le premier combat où il fallait se mettre dans le bain, il fallait rentrer dans la compétition tout de suite, j'ai gagné d'un seul point. Et c'est vrai que je me suis senti meilleur au fur et à mesure que j'avançais, mais je peux dire que tous les moments étaient difficiles, tous les combats étaient difficiles, à leur niveau bien sûr.
Bon, le petit pas de danse, là, c'était quoi?
C'était un petit pas de danse de chez moi qu'on appelle le jazzé. C'est une danse qu'on a de mon pays, le Gabon. Et tous mes coéquipiers qui me supportaient aujourd'hui, ils l'ont reconnu. Et certains Français, parce que je vis en France et je leur montre souvent. Et c'était une manière de leur faire une petite dédicace.
Est-ce qu'il y a d'autres objectifs après ce championnat du monde?
Bien sûr. Je prépare les prochains dans 2 ans. Et ensuite les Jeux Olympiques, la médaille d'or que je n'ai pas pu avoir, et j'essaierai de la reconquérir. Et une fois, si j'arrive à la conquérir, et j'essaierai de redoubler la mise, c'est-à-dire encore champion du monde, encore champion olympique. Tant que j'aurai les capacités de pouvoir le faire, parce que c'est ce que j'aime, et j'essaierai toujours.
Congratulations again, thank you very much.
Thank you, you're welcome.